Thanks for joining us again. My name is Christopher Neufeld, and this is our continuing YouTube series on Google AdWords for Businesses. Strategies to hopefully help you increase the success of your AdWords spend and make money off of AdWords as opposed to becoming frustrated with a marketing system that can be very frustrating if not done correctly. In this video, what we're going to try to address is the aspect of focusing on quality bids. Quality is essential in AdWords, as I've discussed in other videos in this YouTube series, given the fact that you're paying for every click-through, irrespective of how good the customer ultimately is. There's no added bonus paid to Google for a non-customer, or I should say a high-paying customer. As such, you want to make sure that your Google AdWords is extremely focused such that you are only getting those people clicking through and seeing your ad who have the potential to be a paying customer. So what are some of the core aspects of success with Google AdWords? Well, one of the more critical points is the quality of your advertisement, both the content that the prospective customer is seeing, as well as the back end, which is the search terms or the keywords that is designed to trigger your advertisement showing up on a particular search, as well as the negative keywords, which aim to avoid your advertisement showing up on an unwanted search. So let's address some of these key components. First and foremost is the actual advertisement. You want to spend sufficient time working through your advertisement, both the title and its contents, so that your advertisement is focused on getting people who are actually interested in being a paying customer to click through. It's not about somebody who's just interested in viewing something for the sake of free information or for another purpose, such as to educate themselves, to collect material for a school assignment. That is not to your financial advantage. You can be spending lots of money falsely believing that your AdWords strategy is working when all you're doing is making Google rich and giving somebody else some free advice or information where they have no intention whatsoever to actually pay you for a product or a service. As such, really focus on your script that you put out there. Make sure your script reflects that you are a seller, that if they come through and click through, what they're going to be seeing is a sales pitch, and that's what they want. They want to get information, yes, but that information is to instill confidence in them that they are going to the right company or the right person who can deliver the product or service that they're looking for. As such, it's also extremely important that the landing page on your website that is directed to by the click-through is specific to the purpose that the person is clicking on. That means that you don't want somebody looking for a very precise service and ending up at a general website page, whether it's the opening website page or some unrelated page that doesn't address the topic. Typically, what people will do is if they're focused on doing a purchase of a product or a service, and more particularly with a service, they will move from the first page, they will move from the Google AdWords page, click it on, show up at the page that is intended and should be designed to communicate the message to them that this individual knows what they're talking about, can deliver the service, has a call to action in it, and then we'll either make the phone call or send the email to engage that person. As soon as somebody has to search around within the website, they're more likely than not to get frustrated and instead just simply hit the back arrow, exiting your Google AdWords work and the money you spent, and look for somebody else who is precisely on the point that they're looking for. Which in turn leads to another important point that you should always consider. Your ads really need to be specific. They have to be specific to a specific function, whether it's a specific product or a specific service. Sometimes you can do a line of services or a line of products. However, they should be well grouped together that when the person clicks on the Google AdWords, they're going through to a page that provides them all the possibilities within that line. As such, it is often better to have multiple advertisements, each of which is focused on a specific function, as opposed to a broad and general advertisement. The broad and general advertisements are not necessarily the most beneficial because they draw in a range of people. The keywords, which we'll get into next, are typically very expansive. And you find yourself having people who have no real interest in a specific sale, but have a broader search intensity that they look at it and they go back. And they look for something else and they go back. And it's just a waste of your money on the advertising. And this leads us to the internal component, which starts off with your keywords. Keywords are absolutely critical. And really, your keywords should be tied into your advertisement and to the creation of multiple advertisements and having multiple landing pages within your website. Because you want to have your keywords extremely focused. I say this because broad keywords tend to bring in a broad array of individuals that are not necessarily looking for a specific sale and something easy to close. Instead, what you really want to be doing is focusing upon very distinct and specific segments where you can see people having a definite interest in purchasing a product or a service, and then tailoring initially with the landing page on your website, then working back to your advertising script, and then working into your keywords, an entire strategy to direct people through. Because they will start off by using the keywords, which will direct them, which you will put into the search engine, which will in turn direct them to the organic search below, but also the advertising in the Google AdWords at the top, which is directly linked to those keywords. And then they will focus on the advertising, and if the advertising is very specific to their interest, that is what is going to drive them to click through and to truly engage with yourself. Now, with respect to keywords, there's a flip side to keywords, which is equally, if not more important, to Google AdWords, and specifically more important to your budget, and we talk about this in other videos, and that's the purpose of negative keywords. Negative keywords are designed to keep people away from your advertisement. So who are you trying to keep away? You're keeping away people who are simply looking for information, who are looking to educate themselves, students who are looking to work on a paper, students who are looking to research for stuff, prepare for an exam, prepare for a test, people looking for examples, samples, comparative aspects. there's a range of different negative keywords, which we will go into in other YouTube videos, that you need to build up and have attached to every advertisement you create. When you get click-throughs on advertisements that should have been disassociated through negative keywords, you are burning money. The potential for those individuals who we described before of actually wanting to engage you for a paid service or a paid product is infinitesimally low. It is highly unlikely. They're not coming for a paid service. People have to have an interest in a paid service to actually engage people. Instead, they're simply looking for information, and they'll click through, and they'll click through. They'll go back, they'll get information from your competitors, and it's completely fine if your competitors are advertising to these individuals, because they're spending money and you're not. You have to focus on constraining your budget and focusing on people who are actually going to deliver results, deliver profits to you. And that relates to another key aspect, and that's location. Location is extremely important. And you got to use the location definers in Google AdWords correctly. For various businesses, you're only going to look to deliver a service in a specific area. You might not want to go more than 25 miles from your central location, even 50 miles. Now, if you're selling a product and you're selling it with a delivery system that you're comfortable with, the fact of the matter is you might only want to be delivering that product within the territorial boundaries of your own country. You might be willing to do several additional countries, but you have to calculate in the costs, the tax implications, and the potential that it might not be so well received, or you might be pricing yourself out of the market, or there might be issues with respect to delivering stuff that go beyond the product itself and go into technical requirements, licensing specifications, and the like. As such, you want to consider how you control your location, because marketing outside the location that you're comfortable with and you're willing to ship to or provide services to means that you're spending money when there's no potential for real return. Finally, we're going to look into a couple other aspects. And what you want to do is you want to constantly be going back and reviewing your analytics. You want to see that your advertising is actually hitting people that you can potentially make a profit from. So the first aspect that we look at is location. If you find that your Google AdWords are being swiped and hit by people that are outside the country that you want to be in, or outside the locality with which you want to be selling to, you're going to want to look to redefine the arrangement and further constrain it. Because if you're not going to ever provide these people the service or the product, you don't want to be spending money with Google to promote to them. Similarly, you want to track how much business you actually do attract from particular ads. Some ads may actually attract business to you, but some ads may seem to have lots of clicks, but not really get any real business. And it's often hard to define this if you have but a single advertisement out there or just a few. However, if you have your advertisements very specific, you will see those specific products or services that are actually turning into business and you can almost assess where they're coming from the analytics. And you can see which ads are not really performing. And then you have to go back and say, am I going to modify that ad or am I simply going to eliminate it entirely? That's a decision you need to make, and you need to be comfortable with doing it, because otherwise you'll find yourself in a cycle where you constantly put more money in and not really getting results out of it. Finally, you got to look at your pricing of your bids. Your bids are needing to be sufficiently competitive to show up on that first page. So that means you don't want to get far too many bids, but instead you want to get the right bids, the quality bids that we're talking about trying to achieve in this particular video. And to get those quality bids, you need to make the effort to review the success of each one. Put enough money in, but put enough money towards the bid. Limit the number of bids per day initially so that you're not getting flooded with click-throughs. Keep on trying to refine it. In my own profession, oftentimes bids are costing couple dollars, maybe $3, $4 sometimes. But if it's very precise, you have comfort in the fact that you're spending money and seeing results. When you're not seeing results and you're getting far too many clicks to inform the public, you need to reassess your Google AdWords strategy and make it more constrained and generate money accordingly. Hopefully this video has been helpful to yourself. There's definitely more precise information that needs to be addressed, and we're going to look to address that information in other subsequent YouTube videos on the AdWords topic. So keep on staying informed. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like this video. Look to get notifications. And we hope to see you again and provide you some more interesting and hopefully profitable information on advancing your Google AdWords strategy and advancing your business. Thank you.